Welcome to the Wedding Songs Podcast, featuring newly released songs you need to know and the tried and true classics. Get song ideas from the time guests arrive until the last dance of the reception. And now your host, Matt Campbell, founder of MyWeddingSongs.com.
Hi, everybody. I'm Matt Campbell, and welcome to episode number 35 of the Wedding Songs Podcast. Today, I'm going to be talking about the Hot 50 Wedding Song Picks of November 2020. These songs were selected by reviewing all of the top charts on Billboard, YouTube, Spotify, Pandora, all of the lists, and then selecting the songs that are most appropriate for weddings. If you prefer to read the list, you can do so on our website, myweddingsongs.com, and then just go to charts, and you'll see that in the dropdown. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to play a clip of the songs as we don't have the legal rights to do so. But if you want to, just listen to this and then you can plug it right into Spotify or go to the website and click over to Amazon and then you can play a sample of the song. So let's go ahead and get started. At number 50 is the song The Blessing by Carrie Job featuring Cody Carnes. First released May 22nd of 2020. This song is a Christian song and makes for a fantastic dedication to the wedding couple. It offers a blessing to them on their wedding day. At number 49 is Higher Love by Kygo and Whitney Houston, that's sampled into the song. This is a category of EDM music, also known as electronic dance music. It was released June 28th of 2019. It makes for a great dance tune that would fill the dance floor or is a background song that everybody will recognize, even though it was first released by Stevie Winwood. At number 48 is another EDM song, Savage Love, but this is the Lax Siren Beat version by Josh685 and Jason Derulo, released June 11th of 2020. Love this song as it could be a dance tune or as a background song, just like Higher Love before it. And if you really like Josh685, check out his other song, Sweet and Sour, another great background song. At number 47 is Lizzo with Good as Hell, released in March of 2016. It could be a great recessional song, so a song that's played after the I do's as you're leaving the altar area, or just a great sing-along song during the reception and party time. At number 46 is a category I would call more disco, and Dua Lipa dominates this genre, and she released Levitating, but I really love the remix version with DaBaby, released October 1st of 2020, a great party song and dance tune. Another dance tune at number 45 is Go Crazy by Chris Brown and Young Thug, released May 5th of 2020. It's an R&B dance song that you could play to get everybody on the dance floor. I'm not sure if Chris Brown's reputation has gotten any better over the years as he's had conflicts with domestic violence in the past, but if you have Chris Brown fans in attendance, they will definitely dance to this song. At number 44 is The King of Pop, Michael Jackson. First released July 10th of 1979 is the dance hit Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. It's a great dance tune that you could play during the party time or as a background song if guests are not allowed to dance depending on what stage you're at for the pandemic. At number 43 is one of the greatest love songs of all time by John Legend, All of Me, released August 12th of 2013. We have this song on our piano list because it does feature the piano and makes for a great song that you could play during the ceremony or even at the reception as a first dance song. Moving our way up to number 42 is Hey Yeah by Outkast, first released September 9th of 2003, one of the great party hip-hop songs of all time, and will have everybody on the dance floor getting their groove on. Number 41 is a brand new song released October 20th of 2020. It is Ty Dolla $ign featuring Post Malone and their new song Spicy. I really like this song. It just has a great vibe, a great dance tune, and one that I think hip-hop fans will really appreciate. The recently deceased Bill Withers is at number 40 with his song Lovely Day, released December 21st of 1977. Love this song as a processional or recessional song, or as a background song during dinner that will keep it more lively and happy. At number 39 is the top Billboard hit, Old Town Road Remix, featuring Billy Ray Cyrus with Lil Nas X, released April 5th of 2019. Depending on the crowd that's there, if you have a younger crowd that knows this dance, then definitely definitely one that you could play at the beginning of the night to get them on the dance floor. Or if you feel like it's overplayed in your area, then it could be a song that you skip. Just for 80s fans, at number 38 is one of the greatest 80s dance tune of all time. Whitney Houston, I Want to Dance with Somebody Who Loves Me, released May 2nd of 1987. It's been popular as a first dance song, or it could be saved for the dancing time as well. At number 37 is one of my favorite new pop artists, Tones and I, and her hit Dance Monkey, released August 29th of 2019. One of those feel-good songs that you could play as a background song, or if you have the right remix, you could play as a dance tune as well. The song Sunflower is at position 36 with Post Malone and Sway Lee, released October 18th of 2018. For those hip-hop pop fans, this is a great background song that you could play, or even as a garter toss or a garter removal song. Another EDM song is at number 35, Head and Heart by Joel Corey, featuring MNEK, on July 3rd, 2020, released this great dance tune that you could play as a background song or as a party song. Even though it's not September technically, as we're in November, but the song September by Earth, Wind & Fire holds the 34th spot. First released November 18th of 1978, one of the greatest R&B dance tunes of all time. You could play throughout any part of the reception and we'll have everybody singing along and wanting to dance. If you're looking for a modern R&B groove, then at number 33 is You to Love by Ne-Yo and Jeremih, released on May 29th of 2020. A great song that you could add into your mix as a background song or as a slower dance tune or faster dance tune if you have the right remix. It's hard to believe that Happy was released 7 years ago, but Pharrell Williams released Happy November 21st of 2013, and it holds our 32nd spot and a great song that will have everybody in a happy mood. The Christian artist Lauren Daigle holds the 31st spot with You Say, first released July 13th of 2018. A great song that Christian fans will know and everybody can recognize the song as it hit. And at number 30 is Surf Mesa featuring Emily, ILY, I Love You Baby, released February 25th of 2020. A great EDM song, but it has hit mass popularity on all of the charts. Even though it was very popular in TikTok, it's made its way to mainstream and one that you could play as a background song that everybody will recognize that's really up on their new music. Just the opposite of new music at number 25 is an all-time wedding classic, What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong, released September 1st of 1967, but makes for a great parent-child dance song that you could play at the reception. At number 28 is the alternative rock band Panic at the Disco with their hit High Hopes, first released May 22nd of 2018. A great song that you could play as an entrance song or even as a party song. Billy Ray Cyrus was on our list a little bit earlier, and his daughter, Miley Cyrus, is at number 27 with her new song, Midnight Sky, released August 14th of 2020. A song that you could save for a background song or even if you have the right remix as a dance tune for those Miley Cyrus, Hannah Montana fans. At number 26, is Blake Shelton featuring Gwen Stefani. This is their first entrance on our list this month with their new song Happy Anywhere. It's a little bit more upbeat, but it's a great song that you could have during the background, during dinner, or during the cocktail hour. Even though it is a brand new song released July 24th of this year, it has gotten a lot of mainstream play in the country genre. Speaking of country genre, halfway through our list at number 25 is Chris Stapleton and his mega slow dance hit Tennessee Whiskey, released May 4th of 2015. Even though it's 5 years old already, it's a great dance tune or as a first dance song as well. And what I mean by dance tune as a slow dance after bringing everybody up partying, if you want to slow it down to bring everybody on the dance floor, definitely a great dance tune for that. The 24th spot is held by Harry Styles with his first song on our list, Adore You, first released December 6th 6th of 2019. It's like a mid-tempo song, so one that you could play as a background song during the cocktail hour or during dinner. At number 23 is one of the best party songs of all time that's current, and that's Can't Stop the Feeling by Justin Timberlake. Released September 16th of 2016, it will definitely fill the dance floor and get everybody in a great mood and wanting to party at your reception, as this song is one of the ultimate party songs. Going from one of the greatest party songs, we're going to one of the greatest slow love songs of all time that's current, and at number 22 is Perfect by Ed Sheeran, released March 3rd of 2017. It's a perfect, no pun intended, first dance song, and also a song that you could play during the last dance song to slow things down, or basically anytime to your reception, or basically anytime that you could play during your ceremony as well, as it has a ton of covers. At number 21 is two veteran R&B artists, Charlie Wilson, former member of Da Gap Band, and Smokey Robinson of The Miracles. They collaborated for the new song All of My Love, released October 23rd of 2020. It's a song you could play during your reception that all people will recognize their voices. King and Queens is at number 20 by Ava Max, first released March 12th of 2020. It's a more up-tempo song that you could play as a bouquet toss because it really talks about queens being the queens of the world. At number 19 is the Hawaiian Israel with his song Somewhere Over the Rainbow, released November 1st of 1993. A great song that you could not only play for a beach wedding ceremony, but also it could be used as a parent dance or even a song that you could share during the cutting of the cake or as a last dance just to get everybody involved and circling the wedding couple. At number 18 is a very good last dance song, Memories by Maroon 5, released September 20th of 2019. A very popular song still today that you could add to your wedding day playlist. Also released in 2019 is Circles by Post Malone, holding our 17th spot, released August 30th of 2019, and one that you could play as a background song that not only hip-hop fans will recognize, but also pop fans, as this song has hit many mainstream lists. Harry Styles returns to our list again at number 16 with his hit Watermelon Sugar, released November 17th of 2019, a great modern dance tune that you could play during your partying and dancing at the reception. Speaking of returning to the list is Blake Shelton with Gwen Stefani at number 15 with their love song Nobody But You, released December 13th of 2019, a great first dance song or song that you could play at any time during your ceremony or reception. At number 14 is the first song by Luke Combs and his love song Better Together, released August 18th of 2020. A great first dance song, but you don't even have to save it for the first dance. You can have it as a recessional song or anytime during your wedding day. At number 13 is a great party sing-along song, not for every wedding, but definitely for the country fans, and that is Little Big Town's hit Wine, Beer, and Whiskey, released January 17th of 2020. It's really taken off recently, and like I said, a great party song that will have everybody singing along. At number 12 is Jason Aldean's new love song, Got What I Got, released October 11th of 2019. A great song that you could have as your first dance, or you could save it as a slow dance during the reception. Justin Bieber featuring Chance the Rapper and their song Holy is at number 11, released September 18th of 2020. A great pop song that you could add to your wedding day playlist. Billie Eilish with her song Bad Guy, released March 29th of 2019, holds the 10th spot. It is a little bit dark, so you'll want to have a remix of this song if you want to have it at your reception. Could be saved for the dancing if you have the right remix. Chris Stapleton is at number 9 with his song Starting Over, released August 27th of 2020. He also recently released Joy of My Life earlier this week, and one that will also, I'm sure, will be on the list in future releases. But Starting Over is a great new song that you could dedicate to your new wife or husband. At number 8 is 24 Golden featuring Ian Dior, Mood, released September 14th of 2020. It has a great vibe to it and makes for a great background song during cocktails or during dinner. Luke Bryan and his song One Margarita is at number 7, released March 13th of 2020. It's a great sing-along song that you could have as a background song, or if you want to get people on the dance floor that know how to do the two-step. Well, Ocean Spray is really happy happy for this next song, all because of a viral video of a skateboarder. At number 6 is Dreams by Fleetwood Mac, released March 24th of 1977. A great song that you could play during your reception as a background song, or there's even new EDM remixes to this song too. At number 5 is one of the greatest rock bands of all time, AC/DC, with their new song Shot in the Dark, released October 7th of 2020. A great party song that you can play during your reception. If you have a younger generation at your reception that really knows K-pop music, then at number 4 is BTS Dynamite, and they're even on the cell phone commercials, so they're getting a lot of publicity that way too. This was released October 21st of 2020, and by the biggest K-pop band thus far. Alright, we finally made our way up to the final 3. At number 3 is The Weeknd, Blinding Lights, released November 28th of 2019. Love this song as a dance tune, or as you can even have it as a background song if you're not having dancing at your reception. At number 2 is the brand new song by Ariana Grande, Positions, released October 23rd of 2020. Her new album, also called Positions, was released, and all of the songs on that album have really blown up. So if you have guests that love Ariana Grande, you have to check out all of the songs that are on that album that could be wedding appropriate. And at number 1, with his song Forever After All, Luke Combs, released August 18th of 2020. This one, Forever After All and Better Together, are great first dance songs, but also songs that you could play at any time throughout your reception. So there you have it, our Hot 50 Wedding Song Picks of November 2020. If you prefer to read the list, you can do so on our website, myweddingsongs.com. If you want to discuss any of the songs, you can do so on our Facebook group, Wedding Songs Chat. You can get there by weddingsongschat.com. That's our 2 episodes for November of 2020. Next month, in the beginning of November, I'm going to be coming back to the new songs that were released in November of 2020. So be sure to check out that podcast as well. I look forward to that. Until next time, have a great day.
Thank you for listening to the Wedding Songs Podcast. Never miss a future episode. Subscribe today to our podcast. Follow us on Facebook at My Wedding Songs and send us a message about playlists you would like covered.